few years ago, I took the whole family, a lot of friends, and we did a little tour to raise some money for some of the musicians down in New Orleans that lost everything during the Katrina disaster. And I was interested in that because I bought a place. Well, the last time I made some money, which was, I think, the first time, bought an old Coast Guard station down in Sebastian here in Florida, you know, one of these projects we've been working on over 20 years, you know. And we just about had it done, finally, and a couple of hurricanes. Remember when the two of them come by in that 1 week or something, took that sucker down. And I was in a fight at the time with the Army Corps of Engineers or something, you know, and so I couldn't get any insurance, and so it was a total wash. So I knew what these guys were in for down in New Orleans. And I was glued to the TV. That's the new feature of the modern disaster, is that you could have millions of people watching along with you on the TV. And so I was just watching that thing. It was out there in the Gulf, and it was saying it's getting big and bad, nasty, day after day. And finally it gets to New Orleans, it's all that and more. And that's just the natural part of the disaster. Then come the man-made part. That goes on for days, weeks, months. But there's only so much disaster you can be watching, you know, on TV. And so at any rate, we decided we was going to do a little tour and help, you know, some of the musicians down there, are sort of partners in crime, as it were. And one of the groups that came with us, we did a few weeks out there on the road. There were different artists coming in and out, but one of the groups that stayed with us the whole time was a group of sisters from Ithaca, New York. And we had a great time with those guys, the Byrne sisters. And I told them, I said, the next time we get a chance, you guys got to come out with me. We got to sing together. And so finally, for this whole tour, which started back in October last year, we've been working together. And so would you welcome on stage from Ithaca, New York, Jeannie, Annie, and Marie Burns.
Hi, guys.
Here's an old song from New Orleans. I thought it'd be a good idea on that tour to do at least one song that came from there, and I knew too. This is one of them. It was down in old Joe's bar room at the corner by the square. The drinks were served as usual, and the usual crowd was there. Now on my left stood Big Joe McKennedy. His eyes were bloodshot red, and as he looked at the game around him, these were the very words he said. I went down to the St. James Infirmary. I saw my baby there, stretched out on a long white table. So young, so cold, so fair. 17 coal black horses hitched to a rubber-tired hack. 7 girls going to the graveyard. Only 6 of them are coming back. Well, let her go, God bless her. Wherever she may be, she may search this wide world over and never find another man like me. died just to bury me in my high top Stetson hat. Place a $20 gold piece on my watch chain to let the Lord know I died standing fast. I want 6 crap shooters for my pallbearer, a chorus girl to sing me a song, place a jazz band on my thirst wagon just to raise hell as we roll along. But now that you've heard my story, I'll take another shot of booze. And if anyone here should ask you, I've got the gambler's blues.